A lot of people talk to me about what is a theory, because I talk dramatically and how critical it is to have theories that you use. And they say, why a theory? It sounds esoteric. It's who uses a theory? Well, theory has to be in the beginning, because theory allows you to predict with some degree of accuracy, not perfectly, because you've got precession and you've got a bunch of other things. But without a theory, by the way, consciously or unconsciously, everybody operates with a theory. Now, how do we know if any theory is good or bad? You can tell by how predictable the outcome is. So good theories produce best outcomes. I mean, we've got what we call immutable theories, where basically these ones are always work, like gravity, inner attractiveness of bodies in motion. These are, there's no ever an exception. They never go on vacation. They always work. So if you start to understand theory, now what is a theory? I looked it up in the dictionary, and it says here, it's a supposition or a system of ideas blended to explain something, especially based on generalized principles dependent on the thing. So it gets into this whole idea, an idea used to account and understand and justify the situation. Now, what's so interesting about theories is you can never prove a theory. Gravity has never been proven. But you have to, in order to displace a theory, you have to be willing to find one that's better. What Einstein would have had and came up with his E equals mc squared, it went right against the theory that were used by Newton. Newton was the god in this field, and he had all these theories. Some of them didn't quite work, and so Einstein reinvented and came up with his own. He then came up with three predictions. These predictions were based on his new theory that if they held, they would displace Newtonian theory. He said, if they don't hold, forget this theory. So what he did is he made three predictions. They tested all three very, very scientifically, went out on one of the islands. I don't really get into how he did it, but his predictions were precise and contrary to what happened with Einstein. So that a theory is there to help you predict positively. And Einstein displaced Newton because of this. He was able to predict. And in your life, if the better your theories are, the more predictable your life will be and the easier it'll be. So how important are theories? Like we talked about it earlier, initial conditions, leverage, these are all theories. And it's those theories that are going to make you succeed and do things, because you're going to be able to predict far more accurately. So theory is essential right up front. What is your theory? Now remember, you have a theory. If it's not working, it's probably not the optimal theory that you're using. You change your theory. Like when in Japan, Deming went there and they were making stuff that was junk, and he came with a new theory called statistical process control and control charts, etc. And he brought in a whole new theory, and in a very short time, within 5 years, Japan went from making dump stuff to great stuff and cars. So what happens is you change the theory, you're going to ask different questions, you're going to get different answers, you're going to embrace different answers, and these create new theories and strategies, and these strategies are going to make a better car. And if you look at how Japan dominated America because they did not follow the American way of building cars, they built it based on a theory that made the invisible visible by Edward Deming. And Deming is now seen as one of the high 9 turning points in all history, only business person in that list. And the reason was he brought in a new theory, created a new, whole new way of thinking, and that's what made the Japan car so great. Now, the newest ones, the Kia, came in and they started with a Deming theory. They didn't, and you know, Kia now, according to U.S. News and World Report, a couple others, have the highest quality now, even higher than Japan. Not by much. Number one is now Kia. And they just started. Why? Because they have a different theory. They didn't have to mess with American theory. Americans do not make the best cars. Japanese are very, very close, but number one right now is Kia. I learned from Bucky a long time ago that the bigger the picture, the more accurate your prediction. There's nothing in a caterpillar, if you just study a caterpillar, will ever tell you about scenario butterfly. So my entire life, I'm working as much as I can to be a comprehensivist. That is, interested in everything so I can make better choices, better decisions, and have a better perspective. What can I do for you?